All right, Sean will go.
All right. Well, let's get started. We'll move this conversation along, and we will go to our first guest, the one and only Dylan Garcia.
What's going on?
Woo!
Dylan.
Thank you for having us back.
You're already going to be in the show.
Yeah, all you.
This is a new song that I wrote with Jamie called The Message. Waves are breaking, time is running out. What it do, what it is, with me, I say time is running out. You gotta keep on moving, you can never give up. I say now time is running out. And when you work so hard, don't give up on your dreams. Time is running out. You gotta be it coming true, you know what I mean. Time is running out. Said it'd be this easy. No one said it'd be this tough. Well, you gotta keep on fighting and never giving up. Never giving up. I got my eyes on the prize, and the world keeps on spinning. I keep it to myself, maintaining my. Yeah, I'm rolling with the waves, changing with the tides, trying to stay afloat. Got a lot caught on the inside. Time's a waste, waves are breaking, and time is running out. A lot of this new stuff that Jaden and I, you know, were writing and working on, you know, in the pandemic and for the beginning half of 2021, we really vibed together when we were working together in the studio, kind of bouncing ideas off each other. And I mean, it shows when we play together. You know, we just got this kind of synchronicity as musicians, you know. And sometimes it's very tough to find those guys you can sync with. And then not only just perform, but to write and record music with, too.
Jaden's pretty special. And dude, you are as well. I love seeing the way you have progressed.
Thanks, man.
In the past few years. And I love your passion for it. That's one thing I can always, like, I love hearing you talk about your dream. And it's awesome.
Yeah, I just thought, like, you know, during the pandemic, like, you know, it was just trying to find room to grow, you know, like, who are you going to be once the pandemic ends, you know? And I think I was very fortunate to be able to have time to work in the studio and really, really focus on not only what I wanted to write as music, but the actual, not, I shouldn't say branding, but the message that I wanted to convey to people with the music. And it worked out great because, I mean, 2020, 2021, I mean, it's just kind of rocking and rolling.
And super positive, too.
Yeah.
Everything, they, like, that song that you just made, released, or is that released? Or what's
it? It is not. It is not.
Okay, so that one's the one we're going to release on the 2nd.
No, it's not.
No, that one's just
nobody,
new.
Nobody's heard it.
That is a really, really good shot song, dude.
But it really feels good. You know, usually when I perform, I stand up, so it feels really good to be in this kind of intimate, like sitting down, relaxed kind of setting. It's a whole different vibe. Whole different vibe.
And I feel it more. Game. You know what I mean?
Yeah, feeling it. So this next song that we're going to play is a summer song. And it's not out yet. It's pretty much practically done. Jaden, all these songs that Jaden and I did are already done. They're just hidden in the vault to be released when they'll be released. But this one's called Unbroken. It feels so good, yeah, it feels so right. Come by with me, yeah, we got all night. Oh, no, it's gonna be a damn good day. When you feel the vibes throughout your body, hey, sexy thing, come vibe with me. I promise I'll let love aid your energy. Yeah, it feels so good that I'm walking with the chills. Feels so good that I'm walking with the chills. I can feel your vibe from a mile away. Robots meet corazón every day. Two-step, and let's go get lit for free. Let's walk to the beach and feel the ocean breeze. I got goosebumps fucking me from head to toe. Cause I quench your spirit and I love your soul. Yeah, it feels so good that I'm walking with the chills. Feels so good, feels so good, feels so good. Every day, I love the way the sun hits your skin. Yeah, you take me higher than I've ever been, and I don't want this to come to an end. Yeah, you make me feel so unbroken. Sunset's calling, and it's time to go home. Sand and I'm starting to get cold. So I sat up on fire, we can kick it all night. And the sparks burn just like we're fireflies. I love the way the moon hits your skin. Yeah, you take me higher than I've ever been. And I don't want this to come to an end. Yeah, you make me feel so. With me, we got all night. Come vibe with me, come vibe with me, we I'll be honest. So there's a lot of times like, you know, I go on my walks, you know, through the whole neighborhood around.
They wake me up in the morning.
And, yeah, to go wake you up and holler offensive things at your window. But I always go, and it's funny too, because when I'm on this walk, usually Tim hasn't even left work yet. And it's sometimes we're walking late, but it's like, all right, Tim, you can sleep in. Go Giants. Or go Buffalo Bills. Oh, my bad. Yeah. My bad.
There's only one New York team, sir.
But I was talking to our drummer, Adrian Ibarra, and I was telling him, like, holy, like, every day, it seems like every day there's always something new that just happens, like, in my life. Like, things are just happening. And, like, sometimes, like, when I'm on my walk, like, that's my moment. I'm just walking with my dog. I'm by myself with my wife. And it's, like, those moments, like, is when I really feel like, holy shit, like, you believe this stuff's going on right now? Like, whoa, this just happened. And I was talking to Adrian on the phone. I said, man, it feels so good that I'm walking with the chills. And he said, that's a song. And that's how that song came about.
I know what you mean. Because, like, in the life of, like, on our side of the fence, we're constantly, like, everyone in here, they bust their balls, right? They work hard. And everything's, you know, something's always happening. And so when the way I approach life is like, fuck, I can't wait to wake up tomorrow.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, what the fuck's next?
Yeah, man, I don't have no alarm clock. I usually wake up about 4:55 in the morning.
I don't have an alarm clock. That's why you always see me.
Yeah, I'm usually up. Like, I wake up and then, you know, give some thanks right before I get out of bed, and then usually put the coffee on and I start reading, and then usually I devote like the first hour of my morning to reading.
What are you reading?
I just finished reading a book that was written about Kobe.
My man.
And I just finished that one. I read an incredible book before that. I'm actually going to start reading Tim Tebow's book. You know, I like a lot of faith-driven books, you know, because I think a lot of times when we struggle with things, it's because we don't have as much faith as we should, at least that things are usually going to work out the way they're supposed to.
You a religious dude?
Yeah, I would guess you would say. I mean, I was raised Catholic.
You go to Mass?
I have not gone to Mass. I haven't gone to Mass in a while. You know, I didn't, you know, dibbling and dabbling with the Christian churches, you know, because that's the kind of style of church that my wife likes.
Mm-hmm.
But to me, yeah, I would say I'm a God-fearing man.
Yeah.
And definitely. I think having that attitude is what kind of keeps me in check, you know, because I remember back in the day when I was wilding out, there was nothing that would keep me in check back then.
Do you think God has a color?
God has a color.
Do you think he does?
No, I think God would just be this, like, you couldn't
energy.
Recognize it. It'd be something that's internal, what you feel internally. I don't think it was something that you can give it, like, a color.
No, like, on a outside of this world, in a plane.
Like, aura? What is God's aura?
Yeah.
More sunlight.
Yeah.
More sunlight.
I think lately I've been more submissive. It seems like I... No.
Never. Yeah. Never.
Submissive to a higher power.
Yeah. I think once when you realize that, I'll put it this way. Okay, so when my grandpa passed right before everything got shut down with COVID, and you know, when I was with him in the hospital, the day I found out he was put back in the hospital, I went and visited him, and nobody was there, just me and my wife, and we were talking. I actually had like a really in-depth conversation with them. I filmed like him telling his last words, what he wanted to tell, you know, my dad and all my uncles. And, you know, we were talking, and he never knew. He just thought I had this crazy obsession about music. He didn't know, like, this is what I was doing. So I had an opportunity. On that moment, I showed him one of my music videos, and it blew his mind. He was like, oh, man, I didn't know you were doing this. So this is what you've been doing all these years when you say you're doing music. I said, yeah, Dad, this is what I'm doing. And he told me, you know what, you have my blessing. And he just said, remember, don't mess up your life anymore and just behave. And that always stuck with me. Just behave. You know, because when you behave, you know, in the Bible they call it being obedient. But when you behave, you seem to have a lot less problems.
Yeah.
Other than just the worldly, daily stuff we deal with, you know. And that's just, that was like, and then it, the next day when we went to the hospital again, he wasn't speaking to anybody anymore. That was it. He just didn't talk. He was just done.
So you have that little pearl with you everywhere you go now.
Yeah, I do. And I still got that that conversation that I had with him that I videoed.
Oh, you recorded it?
I recorded us talking. Yeah. And it actually was really good. Something told me to start filming, and it actually provided, you know, my uncles, my dad, some closure, you know, with the things that I was able to get with him saying in that video. It provided them a lot of closure after everything happened, you know. Our grandpa was like, he was the main man in our family. I think it was unexpected that it was that time was going to come, you know, because we always looked at him as being such a strong man. And when that time did come, you know, I think, you know, we all felt it really hard, and everyone, you know, grieved their own way. But I think in due time is when I actually, hey, check this out. I got this video of Grandpa talking. You want to see it? You know, and I just broke it out at certain private times with my uncles, my dad. And they were grateful, because I think those things that he said on camera probably weren't things he said to them in real life, face to face, you know. So I thought that
was it private stuff, or was it more general?
Just like, I'm proud of you, I'm proud of my, you know, just like saying, you know, sometimes it's hard for fathers to, you know, say they're proud of their kids, you know.
Yeah. Believe me, not me, but I know what it's like.
Yeah. But I just think, we as men, we process things a lot differently, you know, and having children brings a whole other factor into the equation, because you want to be that role model. You want your children to look up to you, and sometimes, you know, dads, and I will say it too, in the Latino community, fathers are a little bit tough. We're a little bit tougher on our kids than the average, you know.
How are you with yours?
Me and my dad are cool.
No. With your son?
With my son.
Are you tough on him?
In some ways I am, but not to the extent like how it was when I was raised. You know, it's a whole different generation now.
You tell him that you're proud of him?
I do. I try to tell him as much as possible. I try to tell him and uplift him and, you know, speak to him. He lost his grandfather during COVID. His grandfather found out he had COVID and died 2 days later. And that was like his father figure out where he lives in the desert. And, you know, I broke it down. I said, you know what? I lost my grandpa too, you know, and, you know, I know it hurts because you looked up to your grandpa. He was a good guy. I got nothing bad to say about him. But, you know, he's looking out after you. He's looking out after you. And my son, it's kind of tough too, because having these conversations, my son just barely turned 11, but he's got the mentality and the physicality like he could already be 15 years old.
And he's smart too.
Huh? He's smart, yeah. So, yeah, man. But everything's been good, dude. I mean, that song, Walking with the Chills, like, it is that way. Because I think when you get to a certain point, when you can actually start appreciating the day-to-day things that are going on that usually we overlook, I think that's, like, the biggest thing. Because it's, like, it doesn't take much to make me happy, you know? And it's, like, these little things will just, it's, like, damn, like, holy shit, man, life is really good.
Goddamn right it is.
So I was out in the desert. I've been out in the desert working with Ronnie King and Tony G. And you guys don't know, I mean, Ronnie's produced record like the Tupac and John B record, Pennywise, Offspring. He was the producer on the Crow soundtrack. I mean, this guy's had like so many like key albums and songs that he's worked on. And then to throw Tony G in the mix, Tony G's the Chicano rap founder of Chicano rap. I mean, he's the one that basically gave Mellow Man Ace and Kid Frost a career by producing these tracks, removing monumental tracks. In the,
you know who Mellow Man Ace is?
Yeah.
You know he was on our show? Was like, he? in here.
Oh, no way.
I swear. Yeah. Do you remember that?
Yeah.
You were here, right?
That's cool that and he came Phil. Out for the show.
He came all the way out here for this shit.
Yeah.
And it was just amazing.
Well, look, dude, I mean, you guys are doing a really good thing. Like, I do watch your guys' show. I'll tune in on Fridays and watch as much as I can of it on the YouTube feed. But you guys are bringing something that not a lot of people, or at least Vibe, because I don't know if you would consider this a podcast. I wouldn't consider a podcast. To me, this is like a show. This mm-hmm. is a show. It's not a podcast, you know? And you guys are bringing something, like the things you guys do is bringing something so different that once you watch, you get hooked.
I fucking appreciate that.
Yeah, man, that's the truth.
Thank you.
Yeah, I feel the same way. Yeah, that's awesome, though, man. It's cool. Thanks for paying attention.
Yeah.
And we love you, dude. You are a great person in our community, and we appreciate what you bring to the community as well.
See, like, we like, you know, like, people notice, you know, and you may not get your props, but people are still noticing. You know what I mean?
Well, yeah. You deserve the roses, man. You're fucking awesome. You're amazing.
Thanks, yeah. I mean, it was great. You guys do a lot of good things for the community, too. And I think, like, with the prom, like, you guys stepped up, and it was I thought it was incredible what you guys did. And just providing that for not only the youth, but for the community and being involved, like, that's what you're supposed to do, you know? And for you guys to come through in the clutch and something like that with the prom, it just, when you guys asked me if I wanted to play, I was like, yeah, no problem, man. Like, this is really cool what you guys are doing, because some people got left out during COVID, you know?
Yeah.
So, good job. Kudos to you guys.
That was a real tough day. I mean, at the end of the day, I had like 28,000 footsteps that day. Well, I know, because that's crazy. Yeah. And that's like 11 miles, just walking around doing all that shit. It was Chris spearheaded that one, and he did a great job.
Chris is awesome.
Chris did a real good job.
Thanks to the district.
Yeah, they were messing with him, trying to say he was trying to profit. When
they even told him that if they caught whoever went, they wouldn't graduate.
What?
They said that?
That was one of them.
Is that Mr. McCoy's district?
Yeah.
Of course.
I mean,
Oxnard Union. Whatever, dude. Yeah, I still have my kids in that system, so I'm going to shut up.
That's why I just said allegedly.
All right, man. Would you like to, we're going to go to break with this song. So where can people find you if they want to?
Yeah, just go to DylanGarciaMusic.com. You can find all my socials, my music videos, links to my music on those, DylanGarciaMusic.com. If you want to just throw me a quick follow, you can just go Dylan Garcia Music. And don't forget about my good buddy right here, jamming Jaden Seaport Music.
Jaden's a great dude.
Yeah. We jamming. We vibe, man.
If you want to come back to the show, Jaden, come back.
Absolutely.
I just tried to make it about Dylan because it was about Dylan.
It's totally his thing right now.
Okay. Just making sure.
We love you.
Because, like, I saw him, because I kept on asking you questions, and you're like, you did too, Dylan.
He did that look like.
Hey, he was doing it. He was like, what about me?
I was seeing him out of this eye, right?
You saw him move his hands?
The peripheral
view. It wasn't him strumming. All right.
So this is a new song. This one's coming out on, this one comes out on Friday. This is new music dropping on Friday next week. We are performing at Leashless Brewing on Thursday, 6:30 to 8:30, and it's going to be the single release party. We're putting that on there.
Oh, you are?
The new song is called It's a Vibe, produced by Tony G and Ronnie King. I'm going to take you to the top. Wanna see you move, live and dancing. It's the rhythm of the beach on a tropical beat. Yeah, I'm looking at you, you're looking at me. You're looking so fly, yeah, you blow my mind. Live and dancing. And I wanna take you home, just roll with me. Yeah, I promise I'll take you to ecstasy. I'll blow your mind, I'm one of a kind. Live and dancing. Wanna take you to the top. Live and dancing. I wanna see you move, live and dancing. I'ma take you to the top, live and dancing. I wanna see you move, live and dancing. Dark brown hair, dark brown eyes, creamy skin, those silky thighs. I wanna take you home, live and dancing. Looking so pretty, what your makeup did. Yeah, you're at the party. At my crib, I wanna take you so high. I'ma take you to the top, live and dancing. I wanna see you move, live and dancing. I'ma take you to the top, live and dancing. I wanna see you move, live and dancing.
sex on the beach, captivated by the beautiful scene. Yeah, we making love to the ocean breeze, living dancing. And we watch the sunrise, it reflects off your eyes. You're so beautiful, baby, yeah, I'm hypnotized. I can't let you go. I'ma take you to the top, take you to the top, living dancing. I wanna see you move, 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 live and dance it. I'ma take you to the top, take you to the top, live and dance it. I wanna see you move, live and dance
it. That word in my heart, in my head, like a billion times. What does that mean?
Get up.
La venta se.
Get up.
I just fucked it up. La van. La. All right, what? This is No Cover Presents Red Light District Show. I can't speak Spanish, and we will be right back after this. Check out Dylan Garcia and Jaden Secor. Great Koala Drive merch. Go check them out. We'll be right back. Woo!